started, we just need a word of inspiration. What's a good word you're thinking about today?
Fraud.
Fraud? Fraud. Urban, no, this is nice. Thank you.
When I was in high school, I was learning about like the, you know, the protest movements of the 60s. You know, the moment that you discover your parents are not cool, this process was that moment for me, because I was like, Dad, you know, like during Vietnam and all that, did you like protest stuff? And he's like, well, I didn't really protest, but I did do one thing. I'm like, oh, did you burn your draft card? He's like, hell no, you get in trouble for that. I was like, all right, well, this is where we are. She was like, I had a math test. And I knew that I was gonna fail this math test. And the teacher said that if we went to this protest, he would give everyone like a pass because it was really important. So I didn't go to the protest, but I said that I did, and I got a pass on my math test. that was like my dad like sticking it to me.
That makes me think of when I was in my 20s, I got into a car accident, I was fine, but my car had to be towed to a lot, and I didn't know where I was gonna bring it. My trainer was like, my buddy's got one, you should just bring him there. I'm like, yeah, sure, I don't care. He never did. Like, I kept telling, he kept saying like, oh yeah, I've towed it, it's there, we're just getting some parts. They gaslit me for like, probably 4 months. And while in the meantime, it was in this tow lot, accruing fees every day. Till the insurance adjuster was there for another thing. He's like, hey, I saw your car there, and I was so upset, but luckily they took pity on me, this poor 20-something-year-old woman, and they said, guess what, you know, we'll just charge you the deductible, and I sued the garage, and they no longer exist. Take that.
Merritt's story about protests makes me think of in 1993, when I was a baby gay, I was living in a commune in Atlanta. Different story. But that year was the first year I went to my very first gay protest in Atlanta. It was huge. I went down, I saw a bunch of people, and we all sort of marched down the street. It was this huge protest. I got to the end. I didn't know this. It's actually a pride parade. Like, it wasn't a protest. It was a pride parade. I had no idea. Baby gay. But I had a great time.
Returning to the topic of fraud, it makes me think about when I was a teenager, I worked for this wild and crazy ice cream store that had like really wild flavors like Ukrainian rose petal and African violet. They weren't all like flower themed, but those were the ones that I particularly liked. But anyway, the owner, I tried to cash my first couple of checks like at the bank, but it like overdrew every time. He wanted to always pay us out of the cash register, which made me really wonder what was going on there. It was the books, but the weird thing about this guy was I grew up like near where Washington famously crossed the Delaware River on Christmas Eve to surprise the Hessians of Trenton during the Revolution, and every year they have a reenactment of that, and there's like a big competitive process to choose like who is going to be the next George Washington. And this guy who owned the ice cream store was one of the George Washingtons, and you got to keep your costume when you were done, so he would like take any excuse to wear it. So he'd like come sweeping into the ice cream store at the end of the night with like dramatic tape with like a sword, and he'd like ask us about how business had been while like holding us at sword point. So that is what fraud means.
Do you think he's gonna wear it today? Of course he's gonna wear it. It is December 23rd. He is ready to go. He's already in dress rehearsal. Hell, every day of the year is a dress rehearsal.
I don't know if I can take it. Like, it's just so disrespectful. It's disrespectful to George Washington. That's how I feel about it.
I know. Our first president, the man who made America America, well, one of the very white slaveholder men, but he's still, you know, mostly a great man, and we don't need to disrespect him.
I just, like, why can't he wear a Santa suit?
I know. I was raised with Christmas, you've got a baby Jesus, and you've got a Santa, and no those are the only options. Maybe I'm Mrs. Claus and you're being a little frisky.
Also, having the children sit on his lap and asking what they want for America next year.
It's weird. It's weird. And he says you can't tell a lie.
Which isn't even right.
I don't know. You know, I like it though. I kind of do.
What?
I know it's disrespectful, but I don't know. It's like a cool tradition. Our town's super weird because of it. Don't you think so?
I just think it's creepy.
Do you think I'm creepy?
No.
Good.
But like, I'm gonna say something when he comes in this year.
No, I mean, okay. If that's what you feel like, you always stand up for yourself. That's why you're my favorite coworker.
Yeah. Especially could you see if there's any more of the Sarah Palin's revenge back there? I really like the fudge.
I prefer not to, but for you,
thanks. Thanks. Okay, is
it coming? I can see Alaska from in here. Get it? Do you get it?
Daniel, with this flame and this Valentine's Day card, I release you from my love. Ethan, this flame and this Valentine's Day card, I release you from my love.
I'm so, like, flattered that you asked me to, like, come with you on this important self-healing adventure.
I think it's important to have loved ones with you to witness great moments in your life. And moving away from these horrible, horrible men is a great moment in my life.
Yeah, I agree. I'm not totally sure of like the nature of our relationship. Am I like auditioning right now to be a future name set on fire and thrown into the river, or am I just like here to cheer? I guess.
It can be either. It's really. I mean, we can cobble this together, or not. No, it's fine. I plan to get rid of all these, so.
Okay. Cool.
There will be both room in my heart for someone else,
okay.
And also room in this box.
Okay. Do you have a Josh in there?
There is not a Josh.
No Josh. All right. Well, I have Josh in here that I need to get rid of.
You want my lighter?
Oh yeah. I can like burn the name into the paper and then just like set it all on fire.
Yeah, I can say the thing.
Josh? Whoa, okay. Show me again how to do it.
Sure. This guy was a real shithead. Alexander, with this flame and this Valentine's Day card, I release you from my love.
No! I think I can do that. Josh, with this name and this Valentine's card,
sure.
I release you from my love.
Oh!
Don't you feel great?
Yeah, I feel like really like we're just like their spirits are being summoned.
Oh,
and they're
God.
Like speaking to us now, and we're being like, you know what, Buster? I don't care.
Well, hold this for me. There's 700 more names.
Get it, loser, we're going to the SATs. You ready?
Oh no.
Bellicose is to, I don't know, I'm really bad at analogies.
How about incensed?
Yeah.
You know what that one means?
No.
Oh. I don't either.
Oh. Well, you know what?
We're not a good pair for this.
It doesn't matter because we're not going.
Where are we going instead?
I don't know. We go literally anywhere. The movies, the mall, the Grand Canyon.
A reenactment of the Civil War battle?
You're such a nerd. But yeah.
Okay, let's do it. York born and bred, so.
All right. Where is the closest seat? I'm very bad at history. Where is the closest?
Union Battlefield? We could go to, I don't know, Fort Cotton. I think they have, like, a thing there.
All right. So you're not upset that we're, you know, skipping this really important life moment, so we don't have a direct line into college, and we're instead going to go to a maybe battlefield that's probably just an apartment building now.
I mean, we might learn some things.
Yeah. But not a standardized test kind of thing.
Life doesn't happen in standardized tests.
We will be
interested when we go to college. It's more than I can say for most people.
You're going to go to college?
Well, I guess. I thought I would, but...
Where?
I don't know. Wherever will have me.
Away?
Are you saying you don't want me to go away?
No! I'm not gonna go. I can't. I don't want you to go away anyway. That's why I'm sabotaging this.
Well, I didn't know you cared that much.
You're my best friend, man. Do you not know that?
No, I didn't.
Well, you're pretty blind. I mean,
but you know what else is blind?
You're our best friend necklace from 7th grade. That wasn't a clue. It might be plastic, but that doesn't mean it's not true. Still.
I lost mine years ago, and I...
What?
I lost the best friend necklace. And I thought you knew, and I thought I'd sensed it called this.
No! I thought you were just holding it on. I thought you were just hiding it because it's kind of dorky, and it also turned my neck green.
Well, it's not
where we're at. Oh my god! Oh shit. I guess I did put it in park!
We don't like this thing that's happening.
We don't like
stop this thing.
Yeah, it's bad. Make it good. Boo, hiss, boo, hiss.
This stinks.
We could be doing another thing. Gary.
What?
What are we protesting? What is it?
Dude, ask Sarah. She knows.
Sarah, what is it?
Decline tax. We don't like that.
I thought that was last week. This is a different
thing. Am I confused?
I just brought the same boofus sign.
Yeah.
So.
Well, it works for cat, decline,
and ghosts, because they'll die.
It's very versatile.
Are we even sure we're against this thing, actually? I mean, maybe it's something really good.
What if it's like free lunches? I don't want to be against that.
I mean, for that.
We are totally
for this thing!
Dreamsicle. And also I need to talk to you about what's happening here.
Yes.
I feel uncomfortable with the George Washington costume.
What? What? George Washington, one of the guys who may be one of the greatest presidents? What?
Okay, so to be clear, I'm not against George Washington. I'm actually from Virginia, so, you know, there's a lot of, like, kind of, you know, familial, it doesn't matter. I'm uncomfortable with you wearing the George Washington costume to work.
Is it the pants? Are they too tight?
I know he was tall, but he was not that tall. It's their little, that's a lot of thigh. That's a lot of thigh for the workplace, is what it is.
Well, I'm sorry, okay? I am a George Washington interpretationist. I do that at home, I do that at work, I do it walking down the street. That's just what I do, and I'm going to do it here. Even if I am wearing George Washington booty shorts.
We've been getting some negative reviews online.
negative reviews. George Washington received negative reviews. Did he care? Apparently not.
I'm going to pull some up here. So he makes me call him Mr. President when I order my ice cream.
Seems normal.
He says that we cannot look him directly in the eye unless we bring word from Congress of forthcoming funds to support the war effort. That's weird. That's weird.
Listen, it's what I desire. It's what I do.
Is there anything that I could do to make you not want to do this?
I did have my eye on a stovepipe hat and a beard no mustache. Could I just change presidents?
And Lincoln's the one you want to go with.
Or Taft. That comes with a bathtub.
That's true. What about Santa? It is December.
Santa.
He's kind of like the president of Christmas. He's got a delegation of elves. He also has an important founding document, much like the Constitution, that contains an assessment of the relative moral values of all of the citizens who are children of the world.
Can I keep the wig and the booty shorts?
Absolutely.
Then I'm in.
So, I heard you're in for a new presidential costume. Well, we are sadly out of all of our Lincoln stuff, but can I interest you in a James K. Polk? It's just a suit, we really don't know that much about him. There's a little Texas charm, because, you know, that part.
I was looking for something a little bit more like Garfield.
Oh, well, we're also out of James A. Garfield, but we do have Garfield the cat. Oh, no, I'm sorry, we just have Odie.
Does it come with booty shorts?
She just says, come over here, I'll meet you to a drink. So tell me about
you wear a police vest alert.
I hear the markets are a little bit tumultuous right now.
Yeah, it's rough for bonds.
I'm sorry.
Rough for bonds or rough for you?
This is our third date. I noticed that there's a direct eye line between his daughter and your bedroom. I don't know.
You know, sometimes it's fun to be
watched.
We have an open door policy in this house.
I'm a bonds trader, and I can do a lot of crazy shit. I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm gonna.
Gary.
I'm sorry.
I ruined it again, but you lost a bullet.
Well, your instincts are never wrong. So
it's true. That's what the squatter code is.
Welcome to Fort Totten National State Park, Battlefield, and Apartment Complex for Best Friends. I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you all are here. You're going to be able to look out at the window and you can see the apartment of the two best friends who came here as friends, but then they stay friends forever instead of breaking up.
Can I sign, please?
Yes, but you have to sign up with a best friend.
I'm here all the time.
She's not going to college for me.
She's not going to college. I'm just sitting in the window.
I can't? Because I don't have a best friend?
Apparently not. Those are the rules at Fort Totten National State Park and Apartment for Best Friends. Now, if you look at the second floor of the window that's lit up, you can see that that is the former home of Ben Affleck and his best friend, Matt Damon. If you get a best friend, please come back and you can fill out a form.
You can be our third. We have three friends.
A couple of friends?
I think that's happened somewhere. Oh, yes, over there. Look at that window. You can see the apartment of three best friends. David Schwimmer, Jennifer Aniston, and Rudy Giuliani.
Lisa.
So, are you interested? I will get the forms.
Please.
Nothing would make me happier.
Excellent.
You should know, however, if you break up as being best friends, you will have to battle each other.
What?
This is the Fort Totten National.
So you're going down.
I need something to cross a big river!
George?
Yes?
We're out of burgers. It's really cold and there's no food. I'm sorry, we don't even have socks. So,
what?
No.
How did the Congress not provide for all of us?
Well, that's just sort of what they do. Now please just sit down on the boat, you're rocking the shell.
How will they know that I am coming? Me, George Washington, General of the Continental Army?
Not know that we're coming. We're deeply outmatched. Okay? There are a lot of Hessians and four of us. I don't know if you've checked.
The Hessians will bow to me! You will if you wish hard enough.
Do you maybe want to take an oar and help us out?
No! General supervise!
I'm beginning to doubt that story that you chopped down a cherry tree.
I don't lie.
You want to build this country on wishes?
Yes. Isn't that the Constitution? Thank you, that's our show!
Shows like this one in this room, and I hope you all continue to come back on Wednesdays. But there's a reason why I'm extra excited to be with you here tonight, which is because I get to tell you that we have a special run of shows starting this Friday in less than 48 hours in Studio Theater. It is Wits Ask Me Anything run featuring change makers of the DC area. So what this means is that we have different special guests who are going to be interviewed live on stage in front of the audience. I believe Friday night's featured guest is the executive director of ASAP, the Armed Services Arts Partnership, which is an amazing organization. So it'll be really special to hear from him personally. And then an array of improvisers, including some of the folks you're seeing here tonight, will perform an improv show inspired by that interview. And every show has a different featured guest. So I encourage you to check out Wits' website, take a look at who the guests are and what might be good for you to come, because those will be very special shows that you don't want to miss. Cool. But before we get to that, are you ready to welcome your second and last teen? I see a note. Yes, you are. You are ready. Give it up for that.
Too much excitement too early.
Coffee!
Those mornings when you don't have coffee.
Headaches. Excedrin.
Excedrin with caffeine. A nurse.
Nosebleeds.
Band-aids that had like your favorite characters on them.
The Incredibles.
Mm. Scooby-Doo.
Dora the Explorer.
Backpack. Matt. X marks the spot.
Corridor.
Lighting.
Not the best.
Doing our best. Trying really hard.
A minus.
Damn.
SATs.
The black and blue pens.
Staples. Office Max.
Office Depot.
Back to school shopping.
Shopping carts.
Aisles.
The corridors!
Honey, I took the bear that you shot earlier this week and I encased it in concrete and just mounted it on the wall. I caught.
Sweet!
It's sort of like a taxidermy, sort of like a more like industrial sheep taxidermy.
I love you. This is really good. I wish you had asked me before putting the bear in concrete. I was just envisioning, I was such a noble, majestic creature, you know?
Yeah.
When we made eye contact in the forest, I was like, I'm gonna put you in my foyer. People are gonna know.
But that's just,
but now it's like the bear is obscured by all the concrete.
You know, I feel like you just sticking a bear up on the wall is so traditional, you know? And we're not traditional.
Well, couple projects. I killed this bear with my bare hands. I feel like you don't see why this is so important to me. I went out into the woods, challenged nature, and won.
I poured the concrete with my bare hands. This is how I express, you know, my dominion over our house.
Block back that word. More dominion over our house.
Well,
so you're the dominator of our house.
In terms of decor,
so
yes.
Well, yeah, that's all you can see in this concrete.
You're the one that hunts the bears, and I'm the one with decor dominion.
The one with decor dominion. Well, what if I want to be expressed? What if we co denom?
You.
I'm gonna have to go back out to the woods. I got a lot of anger.
I love you,
this is good, except for this particular part. We need to find a way where we can both feel at home together.
Well, you know, I just feel like if you would invite me on some of your hunting trips, you know, maybe we could do some interior design together.
Okay.
I have hands too.
Okay. Yes, you do.
And I've been practicing strangling the pillow.
It's been a year. Thank you for coming in for your annual review.
Happy to be here.
Benny here. You've done a lot of great things, but
I think so too.
I'm a tough grader, I'm going to tell you right now. I don't give out A's, A minus. You get an A minus for the year. That because it's not an A, that comes with a 0.9% salary increase. And it's generous.
Are you kidding me? I haven't seen my kids. It's 2021. I left it all behind. I've been sleeping here. I get an A minus.
Look, some people got C's. Some people got B minuses.
Oh my God.
I don't believe in A's.
But my wife left me.
I see.
And she's like, clearly you're married to this job now. And I said, it's going to be worth it, babe. An A minus?
I feel like you're skipping over the 0.9% increase. That's very generous.
But I gave 100% of my life. 100%.
And I graded it at a 92%.
I put my entire self-worth into this. I have two dogs dying that are just like at home still, and I should take care of it, but I haven't because I thought I could do this.
Cheryl, I do have to remind you that these grades are not final until December 15th, so there is still room to bump it down.
What about the opposite way? Can we get that up a little bit? I can sell my car. I don't need to go anywhere else but here.
No. A? I haven't given an A in 23 years as a manager. I've seen some star students come through here. Barack Obama. I cut his salary.
Wait a minute. What happened 23 years ago? What are we talking about?
Okay, no.
I didn't know. This is how we're going to fix this. You're right, I was only giving 92%, but now I'm 100% in on you.
I've never asked you this before.
No, let's get in there. Let's talk about it.
His name is Carl. Carl Markman. He left a hole in my heart.
No.
I gave him an A.
Yeah.
I gave him a 1.8% salary increase.
That's a good amount.
And he said, I'm going to Allstate. They pay way better. He said, I'm never giving one of those.
same thing. Doesn't that make you feel better?
Married for 13 years and you think this apple is going to get me through this day? I have checked every single one of the cabinets in this kitchen. Not a single coffee bean. Not a single coffee bean.
Well, don't worry. I'm sure I have, I have this green tea. Shall I make you a cup? We have to wait for the kettle to heat.
I know you're trying to be supportive right now, and I really appreciate it, but we both remember what happened in March of 2018, right? The last time I had green tea...
The hole is still in the wall.
We had a really important work meeting, and we were at coffee, and I drank the green tea, and... I fell asleep. And fell and knocked over the stool. And the hole is still in the wall.
My grandmother's stool. I remember yesterday.
How am I eating this apple?
Because it helps. It helps. It's from the earth.
Okay. Baby, I'm really regretting all that lobbying we did to close all the Starbucks in this neighborhood because I could really use a cup of caffeine right now. I have our daughter's rehearsal for the recital later, and oh my gosh, I'm gonna fall asleep. I'm gonna fall asleep.
You mean you're gonna fall asleep while our daughter plays Ode to Joy for 7 minutes long?
That happens to me when I don't have caffeine.
Listen, maybe this is a good thing.
Oh, I'm getting a headache.
Hey,
sit down. Sit down.
Take a cold compress. Maybe this is a good thing. Maybe I'm...
November 2019.
Uh-huh. We're not allowed back in that lane.
We are not allowed in those sacred corridors of that place.
Oh, I thought I turned it off, but that was the wrong turn. I'm so sorry, I know that the noise bothers you when you're like this.
We have not a coffee bean in this house, and I appreciate you being supportive with the apple and the tea and the cold compress, but we've been down this road before, and I think I just need to go back to bed and call it a day.
Wait, no. Just, you can do this. You just have to power through. I'm locking the doors. Okay? We're gonna wait this out together. Okay, you and me. I'll close all of the blinds so it's really dark. And I'll put up that new soundproofing we got so that no noises can bother you. And it's gonna be painful, but I think that when you come through this, you'll see that it was worth it.
Years from now, when you suggest just powering through without coffee, I'm gonna say, babe, do you remember November of 2022?
Something brighter? Down.
Turn it
down.
Down.
Turn it down.
It's too bright.
Way too bright.
I need it to be more rosy.
Rosy.
Rosy. Yeah.
Rosy?
Yeah. Rosy. Can we make it rosy?
That's too much of a red tint. Too much.
I need a little bit of effervescence out of you, so could you turn up the effervescence factor?
More bubbly.
Bubbly.
Oh,
what is it, champagne?
Whoa.
Can we just get some... just some...
Hey, come on, where's...
That's not... You know what?
That's that! Smell any better?
Oh my God.
Possibly from the lighting, could it smell better? Can we get that? Can we get that?
Make it smell better.
This is our kindergarten final project for
you like the new paint job. I know we talked about green. There's a little something special in there. Your mother's ashes. I know we had the urn out and everything. I was just like, it felt impermanent. Now her ashes are in there permanently.
In the wall?
In the wall.
Honey, we were gonna sell this house in like a couple of months. That's my mom in there!
Forever.
I sat by her bedside. Are you serious? That's my mother!
She'll always be here with us, or whoever the future owners are. She was such a wonderful lady. Brought joy to someone. She'll bring joy to, you know, new people.
She'll bring joy to the health department when they come down here and say, you obviously can't have a house with somebody's ashes painted into the walls.
Oh, you don't have to be so hard on your husband. It's a good pink color.
Thank you.
Mom?
It helps in the space, don't you think?
Mom?
Honey, I think this house is going to be a good start for us.
$2 million a year, and you just gave me a raise because, hell, we're Allstate, okay? We're taking accident, and I was wondering, what do we do in that situation?
This is a teachable moment. A plus for asking questions.
Oh, my gosh.
Here. Have some money.
Thank you.
You want to go in there.
The car accident.
Yeah. Okay. You want to project confidence.
Okay.
These people have had the worst day of your life, but then you are going to walk in like some kind of celebrity and make it all better. That's the Allstate way.
Oh my gosh, well.
My leg!
It's getting dark!
Hey there, folks. Don't worry, Allstate's here to take a stand. What's your name there? Hey, let me tell you something. Allstate, hitting your head's a cool thing.
You seem so confident.
Confidence is one of my little names.
Wow.
Let me tell you something about car accidents.
Okay, we've been in this apartment for 4 weeks now, and I'm gonna be honest. I think I need a little coffee now. I think I've eaten all of the granola bars. I've turned all of the oats into overnight oats, and I can't take it anymore. Okay, I need some coffee.
Honey, it's gonna be okay. I never would have believed you 4 weeks ago, but my coffee addiction is gone.
No, but I
come through the other side, and you can too.
You can too.
Just a little patience and deep breaths.
Okay, maybe we can open the windows at least, or...
No,
guys promised I would have my recital, and it's been 4 weeks, so guess what? It's happening now!
No, please.
Our daughter is so talented.
Listen,
she's creative. It's through.
I have nothing to live for. I can't do this anymore.
Our daughter.
Please, just, I know you have a secret stash. Come on.
I have no secret stash. I'm cured.
Come on.
I'm cured of my coffee addiction. You did that. You did that. Look at our daughter, look what we created. This inspiration right here will keep you going.
Don't tell me she's gonna be a marching band kid.
On, destined for great things. The auditions are next week, and I even told her I'll let her out of the house to try out.
Is that really what you want, sweetie? Even though it will kill your father!
Honey, caffeine or no caffeine, I think that's a little extreme.
Don't forget your hall pass, okay? You need a hall pass to come through here.
Look, you...
No, what?
I need a hall pass! Wait, you do need a hall pass to come through here. No.
Talk.
My old bitch of a granddaughter stole my peach pie recipe.
recognize you!